All right, so let's start out by charging each one of these iPads to see how they compare. I've got the iPad mini 7, the iPad 11, the iPad Air 11 and 13 inch, and then the iPad Pro in 11 and 13 inches. Now, Apple gives every single current iPad the same battery rating, but when I actually use them, they're not the same at all. So let's put them through a little stress test and see what happens. I've got coffee, I have snacks, and I'm super ready to spend the rest of the day running these tests. Now that the iPads are fully charged, let's take a quick look at the charging time for each iPad and then get going. And as usual, I wrote down what I think the results are going to be, and we'll see at the end if I was right about any of this. Every iPad has normal battery health and the capacity is at 100%. Now, obviously this is not a perfectly controlled experiment, but it's designed to give you an idea of how these iPads compare. I matched the brightness levels on every iPad. I've got them all set up. The timer is ready to go. So let's get started. We're going to be testing YouTube, gaming, rendering video, recording video, and streaming so that we can get a sense of how each iPad performs. And as always, I'm super curious to see how the smaller iPad mini 7 performs against the larger devices, and then whether the 13 inch M4 iPad Pro is actually king and if it's worth the most money. At the same time, I'm not sure how the 120 hertz on the two iPad Pro models is going to impact the results and how the new contender, the 13 inch iPad Air, is going to compare to any of these. So let's find out. Now, I watch YouTube every day. Yeah, I know, super surprising. And every iPad is rated for up to 10 hours of surfing the web on Wi-Fi or watching video, and then up to 9 hours of surfing the web using cellular data. And for this test, I'm streaming YouTube over Wi-Fi. When we look at the displays, there are two categories. The iPad 11, the iPad mini 7, and the two iPad Airs have a liquid retina display. And then the two iPad Pro models have an ultra retina XDR display, which is mini LEDs. Now, on top of that, when we look at the refresh rate, the Pro displays have ProMotion, which is Apple's adaptive refresh rate of up to 120 hertz. And then all the other iPads have 60 hertz displays. Now, finally, when comparing sizes, we're getting 8.3 inches on the iPad mini 7, 11 inches on the base iPad, and then the smaller iPad Air and iPad Pro. And then we have 13 inches on the larger iPad Air and the larger iPad Pro. Now, as we get to 2 hours of use, there are some super interesting things happening. The base iPad is down to 51% already, which is really surprising. And I'll come back to this later on. Now, the 11 inch iPad Air is next at 57%, followed by the iPad mini 7 and the iPad Air 13, which are pretty close. And then the two iPad Pro models, you could see, are way ahead. And this makes me wonder if there's something going on with the efficiency of the chips. Like, the base iPad uses the A16 chip and the mini 7 comes with the A17 Pro. The two iPad Air models have M3 chips, and then the iPad Pros have M4 chips. And so far, that chip looks like it's either way more efficient than the other ones, or there are larger batteries in the same size models with the Air. Next, when I want to have some fun, I play something relaxing. Alien Shooter is a great option. Now, typically I play games like PUBG and Genshin, but I can't play those at the same time on all the devices. Now, keep in mind that the iPad Pro models allow you to play those more demanding games at much higher settings. So for example, I can play PUBG 120 FPS versus only 60 on the non-iPad Pro models. Another consideration when it comes to gaming is tablet size. The larger iPads are great because everything looks bigger and it's easier to see other players. And if you play with the iPad flat on a pillow or on the desk, it works great. But if you're holding the iPad up the entire time, the larger iPads do feel heavier and it may get tiring over time. When I want to connect an Xbox controller and then stream games with the Xbox Game Pass app, then one of the larger iPads is better. And of course, the iPad Pro models have the best looking display. When it comes to audio, I'm pretty much always using AirPods when I'm gaming. But if you are using speakers for gaming or for watching video, the base iPad 11, the iPad mini 7, and the two iPad Air models have two speakers, one on each side. And the iPad Pro models have four speakers, one in each corner. There's no question that they have better overall sound. And if you are using them for gaming, you can actually have a better sense of where someone is approaching from. Now, of course, none of them come with a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack. So if you want to use wired headphones or a headset, you'll need to either get an adapter or use a USB-C headset. And in terms of battery life, we begin to see just a bit more separation. The 13-inch iPad Pro is in the lead, followed by the 11-inch iPad Pro, the iPad Air 13, the iPad Mini, and then the iPad 11 is in last place. Next, let's see what happens when we put these iPads to work rendering some 4K video. So I fire up iMovie and I rendered one of my 4K videos. The two iPad Pro models finished neck and neck in about 3 minutes and 46 seconds. The two iPad Air models were about 20 seconds behind. The iPad 11 was 54 seconds slower than the iPad Pro. And then surprisingly, the iPad Mini 7 came in last place, which doesn't really make a lot of sense because it has the A17 Pro chip and it's more powerful than the A16 chip on the base iPad. Now, regardless of which one of these ends up being your favorite, you're going to need to charge it. Now, I've been loving this new Ugreen Nexode power bank because it has a built-in retractable cable. So first of all, the capacity is 20,000 milliampere hour, which is a ton. It can almost charge an iPhone 16 four times. It delivers super fast charging of up to 100 watts from a single USB-C. So in real life, that charges something like the 14-inch MacBook Pro to over 50% in less than 30 minutes. And you can charge up to three devices at once with a total of 165 watts. You have a USB-A and a USB-C port, so you never need to use an adapter. And the built-in retractable USB-C cable means that I never get stuck without a cable when I'm on the go. There's also a smart TFT display, so I can track the remaining battery and see all the important input and output numbers. Ugreen also makes two Nexode retractable chargers, a 100 watt version for up to four devices and a 65 watt version for up to three devices. So check out the link in the description for a discount on Ugreen accessories. And thank you to Ugreen for sponsoring this portion of the video. All right, so continuing on with what I do in a typical day, I had to check out some Instagram reels. And by the way, if you don't follow me there or on TikTok, I do publish some short form content that isn't on this main channel. And then moving on again, I wanted to record some 4K 30 footage with the front facing cameras on all the iPads, just to give another aspect of these iPads a test. Now, if you've watched any of my reviews or comparisons, you know that I very rarely use the rear facing cameras because I'm always going to have a phone with me that's gonna have a better camera. But I do sometimes use my iPads for FaceTime or other video calls, so I wanted to check it out. Now, after I finished recording, I decided to watch some Netflix. And the image quality is very good on all of these displays. The video is sharp and crisp, but of course the iPad Pro models come out ahead with a better overall image. And they're also brighter displays and are better suited for HDR content. I almost can't believe it, but at 4 hours and 3 minutes, the iPad 11 is already out of battery. I expected it to last a lot longer, but we'll come back to this later on at the end because I have some interesting thoughts. Now, while I'm watching some video, let's talk a little more about these displays. The iPad Mini 7 has a 3:2 aspect ratio, and the rest of the iPads essentially have the same aspect ratio of about 4:3. At 4 hours and 36 minutes, we see another iPad go. And again, I'm surprised that it's the 11-inch iPad Air and not the iPad Mini. Now, every iPad except for the base iPad is fully laminated, so there's no air gap. And when you use an Apple Pencil, the tip of the Apple Pencil looks like it's touching the content that's being created. With the iPad 11, you will see a bit of separation between the tip of the Apple Pencil and the content itself, especially if you look at an angle. And if you're not sure which Apple Pencil to buy, check out this video. Now, at 5 hours and 26 minutes, we do see the iPad Mini 7 run out of battery, followed relatively closely by the 13-inch iPad Air at 5 hours and 42 minutes. And looking at the two iPad Pro models, it doesn't seem like I'll be getting to bed anytime soon. In terms of resolution, we are going to see some differences, and the higher resolution doesn't really matter to me when I'm watching content, but it is important when I'm multitasking. On top of being able to see more content without having to scroll when I'm using the larger iPads, it's also the best option when I have two apps open side by side because I have so much more room to work with. Now, next, I checked out some more Instagram reels, and let's take this opportunity to talk about pricing. The iPad 11 starts out at $349 and the iPad Mini 6 is $499. Moving on to the iPad Air 11, we see that it's $599 and the 13-inch model of the iPad Air is $799. And all four of these iPads start out with 128 gigabytes of storage. When we look at the iPad Pro models, the 11-inch starts at $999 and then the 13-inch starts at $1299. And both of those models start with 256 gigabytes of storage. Now, back to the batteries. After 7 hours of use, I'm super super impressed by the iPad Pro models, but I'm also super tired. So as I always do at the end, I'm just going to play YouTube videos until each one of these run out of batteries. I've got a playlist of some of my favorite creators like I always do, so let the games begin. Now, it's interesting that with both of them having the same chip, the larger iPad Pro is well ahead, even though it has to power a larger display. This may simply come down to a larger battery, which is super nice considering that the larger iPad is thinner. At 9 hours and 59 minutes, again, super impressive, we see the 11-inch iPad Pro run out. Now, coming back to reality for a moment, I'm very rarely going to be using any of these iPads for this long without having access to a power outlet. Even if I'm editing video on a flight and I'm using the iPad as a second display with Sidecar, I either have it plugged in or I bring a power bank with me. All right, so looking at the results, the iPad 11 was the first to run out at 4 hours and 3 minutes into the test, followed by the iPad Air 11 and the iPad Mini 7. Now, at first I expected the iPad 11 to perform better, and I was wondering if it has to do with the A Bionic chip versus the M chip. But at the same time, the iPad Mini 7 beat out the 11-inch iPad Air, which comes with an M3 chip, so it's a little bit all over the place. In third place, we have the 13-inch iPad Air at 5 hours and 42 minutes, which is more than an hour longer than the 11-inch model. Then the iPad Pro 11-inch went on for almost 10 hours of use, which is great. And finally, after 11 hours and 31 minutes, the 13-inch iPad Pro finally runs out of battery. Now, looking at these results, we see that the larger iPad Pro is definitely king. This wasn't the case every year, and let me know if anything about the rest of the results surprised you. The iPad 11 was also super slow to charge in the test that I filmed, which wasn't always the case. It was different than the charging test that I posted on Instagram Reels or TikTok. So should I get another iPad 11 just to double check? Well, maybe. And now we only have one thing left, my predictions. And was I right? No, but I had a lot of fun. We're either seeing the M4 chip be much more efficient, or maybe the iPad Pro models have a significantly larger battery. And the mishmash of iPad 11, Mini 7, and 11-inch iPad Air doesn't really make a whole lot of sense to me. So let me know what you think. If you're looking for more information about any of these tablets, I have dedicated reviews and comparisons, so check them out. You know what I always say, buy it nice or buy it twice. Good luck and see you soon.